Good morning, grasshoppers. Time for some diligent daily training. Today is my grandson's moving up day as he moves up to fourth grade. Or pre-K-4, I should say. Yes, pre-K-3 is a thing here in New York. Pretty cool, I have to admit. He's learned so much. He's so good and sociable. Good morning, the QMJ Master. J Master 2, how are you? Yo, see you in the tournament. If you're not in the tournament, it is in the standard dojo. Let's rename that. I know it's not allergies. I'm a little worried it's something else. I'm very anxious to do some more collaborations. I have to actively seek a co-streamer among all the digital artists that I have out there. And they do not have to do chess. They can do their own thing until they get comfortable. Hopefully Anu will join me soon. It is a very busy schedule at the moment. Rogan Joe Sloan, good morning. Oh no, I'm playing the game already. Duparno Methodist. Good luck. I'm here for once. But you were streaming a little while ago. I think I saw you streaming. Or at least I remember seeing a notification that you were streaming. I don't know if it was even today, honestly. Perhaps today I will get around to ironing out my repertoire from the various books that I have, my sleep schedule. Oh no, I have a feeling that I know what that means. Let's see here. Can he hold on to this pawn? I have to think about this for a moment. Should I play c5 straight away against the pseudo Varisov? Oh no. We all really, really need sleep. That goes without saying. Good morning, Nico. Sorry to see that you... Alright, we're hitting the center. This is my, Now I know what to do. Because I don't want to give up the e5 square. Let's keep tenderizing the square d4. Whoa! Dudovich. At long last. An And is my opponent really going to get the move e4 in? I don't know. We will find out if they dare get the move e4 in. Well, that's a bummer. I don't have the bishop pair. But I am getting it back. Oh, bummer. Bummer, bummer, bummer. My opponent really wishes to do that to me. All right, well, let's keep on dancing. Let's just keep on dancing. We're gonna dance the night away. Knight versus bishop, pawns on both sides of the board. This is definitely a little worse for me. Minus 40 seconds. Keep activating the night away. And now for something completely irrelevant. Can we make his bishop a bad bishop? Bad bishop. I always find those perplexing, the draw offers. Let's just keep the bishop bad. Make sure that pawn can't move. Remember, John, it is a 2-second increment. It is not forever.
Time is running out.
Yes. Whoa. Yeah, I was just bluffing. I honestly was just bluffing. Is that the tempo that was needed? 2 seconds, everyone. I have no idea how I'm going to win any given game. It is an amazing amount of patience. If you check out my Instagram story, Fabiana Caruana says it best in the press conference that you can never expect to force a win or have a win at any given moment. Two whites in a row. What did I do to deserve this? I've only beaten I am Gopal twice before. Let's bring that board up a little bit so that you can see the notation properly. We're going to keep pace with what's going on here. I'll play something less than the main line. And it has succeeded. I don't even have to worry about ruining my pawn structure. It's quite incredible. It is quite incredible. Improving everything that I possibly can. All right, now it's time to go for the bothersome weakness on that square. Hopefully my bishop on e3 will not look too silly. Now for something absolutely ridiculous, money penny. Oh no! I did it to myself. That's so funny. You lose. That's very amusing. I am Gopal. Snagged me again. What is my score against him? I'm 2-7. You got my trick, all right, Walking Death. Yes, I did. I set it up, in fact. I'm going to enjoy looking at that game again later. All right. I am Gopim Shimba MBA, Master of Business Association, Master of Business Administration. I don't know. I didn't get to do my puzzle streak this morning. I'm a big believer in trying to do a bit of puzzle streak every day. So many games going on right now. Let's see if we can sneak a couple in right now. It always remembers where you are. So for example, we left off yesterday at 10, right? So we'll find the pin. First set up the pin. Looks like mate and two. Double diagonal mate. Let's see if we can get five in before basic fork time. On promotion time. There's a great pawn promotion in a Fabiano lesson available on chess.com that I highly recommend. This looks like a skewer, but is it just a simple skewer? I guess it is. All right, back to the tournament. We did our five. AIM. I'm trying to think of who this could be. Who could it be? Bring our board window back just a little bit. Oh man, they're going slowly. I miss working with you, sir. I have a great format for us, though. Great format for us. We're going to do an hourly arena together. There may be some losing going on in the time department, but we're going to do one again. This weekend could be tricky, because I have on Saturday the finals of the Society Team 9 Ball. And a new season starts next week, so I have a little bit of work to do. And the other problem is that I want to get a couple of Pegasus 4 study streams done. Because Pegasus keeps me working. Unfortunately, I haven't been working. Me? Was that you? I got my trick. Walking Death, as I'm, I don't know if I'm pronouncing it right. Encopemes. Encopemes. So I also figured out that I need a bare bones streaming system for Traveler. Right now, this layout is so demanding in my Streamlabs that I just break down. So I'm gonna have to actually switch my entire layout to a scaled down traveling layout. So I have to figure out what to do about this. So we're gonna have to look whether I go back to an old layout that I was able to use way back when. Whoa! Put our game back. Our camera. Looks like the microphone is working though, at least. Testing, testing, testing. And then I need the webcam. I've learned a lot about the webcam. I am back. So I definitely know this layout works. I've got a bit of work to do on the other one. So when I go to the other layout, wow, that could solve my problem, but I'm getting a new laptop. Ironically, I just asked the tech department for a new laptop. So they're getting me another 1 terabyte, 16 gigabytes of RAM, Windows 11 capable. I figure the problem is that my old laptop, because it's not Windows 11 capable because of the video card, that is primarily why I'm SOL. Gamer Bolt. There's a really expensive one on Amazon here. The world ain't all sunshine and rainbows. It's a very mean and nasty place, and I don't care how tough you are, it will beat you to your knees and keep you there permanently if you let it. You, me, or nobody is gonna hit as hard as life. But it ain't about how hard you hit. It's about how hard you can get hit and keep moving forward. How much you can take and keep moving forward. That's how winning is done. Now, if you know what you're worth, then go out and get what you're worth. But you gotta be willing to take the hits and not pointing fingers. This one is a beast. Because of him or her or anybody. Cowards do that, and that ain't you. You're better than that. What doesn't support USB Type-C? Is that the old one? Oh, a native Thunderbolt 3 port. So my new laptop needs a Thunderbolt port. We will see. Well, that one goes in the machine. That's not going to work. Let's go back.
Ready.
Oh, and we're back. Somehow. Oh no, Lee Chess will restart in 5 minutes. Max Chess. It's about how hard you can get hit and keep moving forward. That's how winning is done. You're better than that. Let's go all out here. What? Now where are you going? Where do you think you are going? Craziness abounds, folks. Yes. And now for something completely irrelevant. I'm running for it, folks. I am running for it. What did I do this for? All of this discomfort, and I'm not even up a pawn. All right, moment of truth. Okay. This is fascinating. So this is my original plan, but he has bishop to f1. So I'm just gonna keep mucking about and hanging out. Because you never know what you're gonna get. He's not really going to open up the F file, is he? I doubt it. I mean, his queen is nearly trapped. Now what do I want to do? Good morning. Uh-oh.
It's raining, Grandpa.
What does that mean?
It's pushed to 12. I don't know if you can make it.
I can make it.
You can make it at 12?
I'm making it at 12.
All right. Gonna help Bubby choose his outfit today?
What? I've got to get to choose his outfit. Hold on, 10 seconds. What is going on? What did he move? Knight C3?
Okay, first we're gonna pick out what we're gonna wear today. Oh. We have a suit, and then we have a nice skirt with a white pants. What do you want to wear? Check. We could do numbers right after. Which one do you want to wear? You want to wear this one? Oh, I think W chose for you, Grandpa.
Hey. Oh my gosh, look at those two suits.
I know, so he has this one, which is kind of more casual. But it's very cute.
I like it. Let's match.
So he wants to wear this one. You have white pants?
I don't have white pants, but...
You have a white shirt?
I have khaki pants.
You could do a white shirt and black jeans. Pants. Well, these are... This black is like jeans. This is blue, actually. I know it looks black, but it's blue. See the shirt's blue?
Yeah. I didn't realize my shirt's blue.
Yeah, I think this will be nicer.
Yeah, I'll change the khaki pants. That way I'll be close. I don't have any white pants now. I'm not car pop. What? Mr. Number Blocks. Does he have school today?
Yes.
Are you wearing your outfit to school that you're graduating in? Changing, eh? So what do I wish to do with this fellow? C3 on move 2, huh?
We have to go have some breakfast, Bubby. If you want to do this in the morning, you have to wake up earlier and do it. You can't start doing this at 7:20. Anakin.
Let's play this like a hedgehog.
I don't know if Divin can make it, though. He's supposed to go to work afterwards.
Oh, yeah. Alright, looks like we're simplifying whether I like it or not. You're attacking a lot of pawns. Let's see what we can get done here. What's up, Bubby?
No friends. Oh, what did you make?
L.
L. L. L.
Oh. That's
I had to use his melatonin last night.
Oh, yeah?
That was unusual.
It worked faster than the other one. Or he was just tired and he just needed the help. Anakin!
Well, that was interesting.
Where are you going?
My opponent just gave up the bishop pair without being asked. That's so weird.
Okay.
And now for something completely different. Let's keep everything tagged.
2 minutes
and bagged. packed.
Oh.
And packed. Yeah.
You need to pee is what's going on.
What's happening? He's dancing around?
Yeah.
What's that?
He's going for one of these.
Oh.
I know what you were trying to get, but you can't really get stuff because you're jittery because you have to pee.
Can I go back? Put my rook on the 7th rank?
All the ways. All the ways. All the ways.
I don't know about...
Can grab one at a time, Anakin. Have to grab all of them at the same time. Hey, you're not bringing those out of the room. Bring it back. Anakin John.
Bring those back.
Bring them back. You can play with them in here. Play with them in here. Here, you want a table? Right, look. That's fine. You could use that chair. You only have a minute, you know.
Close to the sun.
It's full in a half hour, you know, so you gotta eat something. Wasn't planning on packing you a lunch today.
Check. Well, I want to play it that way.
On table.
I don't actually have much of a choice, do I?
You want a table? All right, here. Dad, I will be in charge of these, and he will play with them while he eats his breakfast. And
sounds good.
I will bring them back up. Come on, let's go. We're bringing them up with us.
No, this is.
Yes, we're going to use the table downstairs, honey. We have to go and eat.
Let's see what we get out of this deal with the two bishops. I got skewered. That was a good move. That was a good move. Or was it? It was a good move. It was a good move. That was a very good move. Well, that's what I get for being overconfident. So many days in a row of winning. And I'm settled back at 2170. Basically because, hey, Christina, how are you? Good morning. You were on fire last night. Even if your audience wasn't necessarily there for you. I liked what you were up to. It was a fun game. Time to hydrate, eh? Choose this water bottle. I have about a half a dozen water bottles over here just in case. I always forget to refill them and bring them back up. You didn't stream till the early morning hours. What are you doing up so early? You must have gone to sleep, or did you go out? I'm trying to think, when I left you, it was around 9 o'clock, Christina. And you gave me a tremendous idea for a collaboration last night when you were streaming with those guys. Not unlike Hand and Brain, where you do the playing and I do the talking. And it would have to do with advice, not unlike the Moobot. And basically it'll all be recorded, so all the advice will be there for the keeping later on. Is Anu coming? Anu is organizing the Mongolian team right now, and she's preparing for the Olympiad. So she has her hands full because she's running the summer programs in Mongolia. My other co-streamer, Christina Anu Bayar, she's a women's FIDE master and a FIDE instructor from the same year I became a FIDE trainer. FIDE is the organizing body of World Chess. And I became a FIDE trainer officially, even though I've been teaching chess forever. Yeah, I lost a record number of games today. That was crazy. But I had some good opponents. Let's check them out for a moment here. I lost to a 24-56, mainly of my own accord. I think that I was doing fine in that game. We will look at that game just now. Lost to the 22 and the other 2400. So no shame, in a way, losing to the 2400s. But the most recent game, let us check it out for the most part. Hold on, I didn't mean to do that. What time did you actually stop streaming? I don't know, I could have looked it up this morning. But when I came in to set up my stream, you were long gone and you'd handed it over to Gory Hole. Oh, this is the way to bring it up in our stream. Yeah, so I don't know if I'd necessarily have a plan against C3 immediately. We may have to consult. We may have to consult some of the anti-Kings Indian books. Let's just do that. Like, I can play G6, I can play E6, C5 like I did in the game. Alright, let's see what we got. Want to see something here.
This nation owes you a huge debt.
Thank you for the follow. That is amazing. Thank you so much. I'll be right there to firmly acknowledge you in just a moment. Ark. We're just checking out. Need to bring this book down anyway. Do I have a duplicate of this book up there? On the tops of the bookcases, I have duplicate books that I have, according to Nico, offered to viewers at some point or another. So this is not a complete repertoire book. I just need to see something here. Is there an anti-King's Indian book that I can see? Down here in the King's Indian section. Nippon attacks. Well, let's just skip that for now. If it's not readily available, I know the book that I'm looking for. It may be in a repertoire section. Christina had a really amazing stream with, was it Jack in the Box? It was quite creative, I have to admit. I could almost play that game. It does require a bit. GK2564, thank you for following. February 5th, 1964. Not Garry Kasparov, obviously. But I don't have a plan against this, so I defaulted to a certain extent to e6 followed by c5. This is always a good standard plan to bother the d4 pawn. And then you can allow for taking over the center later. Now the problem in this position is what to do about the bishop on c8. So we solve that problem. So it looks like we're doing pretty well. The assessment for us is, of course, showing that we're better. Did I have a better move? Because it says -3. These things are all negligible, by the way. Where are you from, GK2564? And is your birthday February 5th? So yeah, there's some really toxic people, I tell you, even among the streamers. Last night, poor Nick in...
Nation owes you a huge debt.
Poor Nick in Christina's stream, who was playing Jack in the Box with her, and Salty Clown, it's like... I mean, he was just trying to be funny. I'm assuming I wrote off Salty Clown as just trying to be funny in a bad way. I asked India, not Indiana. No way. So you've been around a long time, Foggy player. I've always wanted, in fact, I should have Soggy Bottom. Soggy Bottom is the one that I think I should go for. If I had to guess where Christina is, she seems like she is a UC San Jose or a UC Berkeley person. Because she does math, I'm fairly positive that she's at Berkeley. It is pouring out there. I may have to close my window. Castles was a mistake, eh? Could I have played a better move as black? D6, queen C7. It's really holding fast to that 0.0. Better for black. I do like light red. California is an amazing state, Rogan. What are we talking about? How did they fail? That is the U.S. state closest to you, perhaps. Short of Mexico. I think I like everything about California except for... I'm trying to think if there's something that I don't like about California. Well, the politics, obviously, the randomness of the politics, especially in chess, by the way. The chess politics between Northern California and Southern California is horrible. So we're back to being, now queen to c7. I needed a better move. I could have played d5 to firmly fix this, but I just didn't like having my bishop here. There's nothing wrong with this position, obviously. But certainly queen to c7 is uncalled for because of rook c1. Wait a minute. I think you're describing New York too. Mississippi. Alabama. Oh, forest fires. Natural fires. High rent. That's New York. Chicago. Drugs. Homeless people. Philadelphia. I think you're describing the United States. Fire. Except for the natural fires, you're describing most of the western coast. Because of droughts. But no, that's almost all of the United States. You have an idea, yeah? I like to see people using the emoji. What's your idea, Foggy Fire? Finally, someone uses the idea. Feel it. Yeah, I've become a rural man because of living outside Manhattan now. But I lived in Manhattan so long. All right, it is starting to really get windy, and the rain is. I'm gonna put it down to a little dribble and hope that it doesn't get on the books here. Let's migrate the books away from the window. That'll be the simplest solution. Right? Isn't that the simplest solution? Just move the books away from the window. Including the FIDE trainers guy that I worked on. Positional sacrifices, 100 chess master trade secrets. Drazen Maravich's The Secrets of Positional Play. And my grandson's chess pieces. He brought in his chess pieces. He has his own chess set. And he brought it all the way in up here. Feeling. Let's see if I can learn from my mistakes. So this was my major blunder. I'm literally doing very okay here until Bishop F8. Should I have just played G6? It's possible that G6 was the simplest solution. Right? Because he doesn't have Queen H6. I had to evict him and then go after it. In any event, Bishop F8. FG7, Bishop G7, and then Rook C1. Now, Rook takes E2, amazingly enough. Rook takes e2, threw away hardly any of the advantage. But how bad is it? Could I have just played queen to c8? Is that true? And everything is hanging. Oh, okay. It didn't count it as a real error. Queen to e5 was a real error, allowing the skewer. Just preventing any counterplay, consolidating. How about that? I'm looking at my losses from the tournament that was just held in the dojo. If you have not yet joined the dojo, then you should have. If you've not yet followed Chess Bay, then you should. And take a quick look to see where she ended up. She was like at 800 followers. She should be over 1,000. 877. She's got a huge advantage. So yeah, back to the toxic suggestions. And when I offered Rogan, as I did for you, to remove the bots in the stream, right? Because she has a lot of viewers, obviously, and the bots are not going to be noticed, but they don't count as viewers. So it's like, eh. One more follower, and I hand out 5 gifted subs, everyone. One more follower, 5 gifted subs. Yeah, I allowed a very simple tactic there. That was really sad. At 8 o'clock, we're going to do an hourly arena. I'm going to see if I can toss all of my rating points again. Rogan Joe Sloan, our esteemed YouTube editor. Thank you so much, Rogan, for the external video card suggestion. I don't really want to give up. Wow, look at that lightning. That was really close. I might want to sign off. Can you imagine to be a streamer hit by lightning on stream? With 13 people in today's arena. That was rough. Let's see. Let's just see what happened in this game for a moment. So all's well and good. Bishop g4 is not recommended. I'm not a huge fan of knight c6. I do like removing that defender as fast as humanly possible. Let me see what my other options are. D takes e5. That's also an option. Because it is premature, by the way. In this position, they're supposed to play knight f3. So when they play knight f3, now black has a little bit trickier decision on his hands. So I've often gone for b6 and e6, which are very reasonable. I've never considered g6, but it's a huge loss ratio as well on the 40%, 40% side. You did miss the viewer playing session, but that's all right. We have it every day. We have it every day just before this. And then on Saturdays, we started a little later. We started around 8 o'clock. So 15 minutes from now on a Saturday and a Sunday, we will be doing our, when I play the viewers. Let me change my stream title. Yeah, we run a standard Swiss, and I usually play everyone. Absolutely, sir. The 6:30 a.m., which is just about an hour ago, we run it for about an hour and a half, an hour and 10 minutes. We play 3-2 for an hour and 10 minutes. And 6 lucky viewers beat up on me. So I'm just looking at the six that did beat up on me now. I like the accountability of a tournament too. I don't understand how anybody can play unrated games that are unaccountable and then accuse their opponents of cheating in a game that doesn't count. Can you imagine accusing an opponent of cheating in a game that is casual? Like, for example, if it were a casual game, right? And you're analyzing with a friend and you're talking about the moves. Literally, you're talking about the moves. How are you doing, Donnie? Good morning, sir. How is Magnus? Let's get some emojis flying across here if I can find some for the morning. Somebody finally used the idea emoji. I like the idea emoji. More followers should use the idea emoji when they want to make a suggestion or contribute to the stream. They should definitely do that.
Six Bubby's hair up now. It's not going to last till 12, I'm realizing.
You don't think Bubby's hair will look extra cute at noon? Oh, yeah, wait with the gel. Oh, they won't let you. Oh, I remember this one now. Everything's good about this for me, except for my next move. And I should just play A6. Before I do this, let's do the learn from your mistakes. How are you doing, Donnie? Are you playing chess at all, even casually? Are you playing some blitz on at least cheese.com? Candidates start today, by the way. Candidate event. I posted the press conference, Fabiano's press conference that I liked the most. We can watch it again. I actually thought about watching it again on YouTube. Changing my category to just chatting, talking about the FIDE candidates tournament. But at this point, you should be on your way to work, Donnie. What's going on, man? Dropping the kids? What do you do, sir, now that you've got more than one? I can't even fathom having youngsters anymore. I really can't. My kids are 25. Soon to be 26 and 21. Angels that they are. And now I played A6 when I should play Bishop E7. Just extract myself from this. And I was very concerned about this. That was one of the reasons why I actually shifted gears. I wasn't entirely positive what I was going to do in this particular position. Can I play knight f8? I see. Knight f8. That's a hard move to see. That's almost as deep as the trap that Fabiano set for Kramnik in that game in 2000. I don't remember if it was 2017 or 2018. It was. Oh. All right, I am on my way. Do I leave the stream on and or do I pass you to someone else and then restart? That is the question. Let's raid Chess Lions. one of my favorite guys, by the way. Hopefully he's not signing off. He's doing the hourly Super Blitz arena. We could also do Ketty. All right. More later, everybody. Have a good day. Ciao.